Hi, my name's Scott Hallam. I am a carpenter. I build houses. I have been married for 24 years to Rachel, and I have three children. So the men's circle that I go to runs in a way that it has a safe environment that men can express anger, grief, sadness without being judged. I go to men's circles primarily to help myself. I'm very good at helping others, fighting for others, doing stuff for others. I guess I struggle to do things for myself, look after myself. So primarily going to a men's group to look after myself emotionally.
My name is Rob, and I'm a site supervisor for Titan Trailers. I'm able to take a look at why I'm doing certain things, and it's a place where I can just get really honest with myself and just take a look at what I'm doing in the world.
Hi, my name is Travis. I'm 50 years old, a dad of two adult children, married for 27 years. I own a business that has about 40 staff, and I'm involved in charity work. I'm chairman of the Big Buddy charity, which is for boys who don't have dads. I've always been drawn to what I would call male community. I love the superficial banter that men can have, but I enjoy and value depth of relationship.
I attend men's circles because I have a passion to be real.
There's a culture in men that it's not okay to speak about your emotions.
And because of that, they will tend to shut away and pretend that they've got things under control. Now, the bad side of that is that they did not always have the opportunity to have everything under control, and usually sometimes they sweep it under the carpet.
There's probably a lot of men out there that think that this is a whole bunch of wuss and woo-woo. But what I'd say to them is, have you tried it?
Being the tough guy, I think it works in certain situations, but we're not at war with anyone, so there's really no need to be in fighting mode all the time. So so why would I want to walk around with that energy in my body all the time?
I think we've learned to be, as men, we've learned to be reserved and to, in a way, protect our manhood. Real manhood doesn't need to be protected. It just needs to be declared.
Life has only got as much meaning and purpose as you give it. And it's my job, it's my responsibility to give my life meaning and purpose. And being in a wheelchair doesn't actually remove either the responsibility for finding the meaning or purpose or the opportunity for finding meaning or purpose. I'm a father, a husband, and I've learnt that what I know and what I'm aware of about myself profoundly affects the way that I behave and act, and the way I influence those that are closest to me, that I love the most. And it's a commitment that I make to being the best influence and the best man that I can be.
There's strength and power in emotion, and there's strength and power in discovering who you are on the inside. Sometimes the right thing is, don't be afraid of that. Yeah.
There's currently a lot of discussion about toxic masculinity, and that's why the men's work is so important. It's because we have to examine the concept of masculinity, not to say that all of it is toxic. There's certain dark sides of it that we don't accept the behavior of. We correct the behavior, not the person. We're not saying that the person is bad. But the behaviour is bad, it's not acceptable.
Don't be all that surprised for you. The things that happened to me as a young person and growing up through life were normal. My normal isn't the same as another man's normal, and that something that happened to me that caused me to create a belief of which I constructed judgments, emotions, and packaged it all together so that I could keep myself safe. Have been keeping me safe, but I've discovered that those things that I needed to keep safe from long ago no longer serve me. And so moving forward, there's an undoing that needs to be done.
The challenges that I've had in my life have been things like depression, anxiety, these spaces where men gather. It's like a rite of passage. There's a chance for other men to see me and me see other men and express my vulnerability.
Yes, I don't really divide people. I just I love being with all people. I think it's absolutely essential to love everybody. If you don't love everybody, you don't love anybody.
An extended family or community is incredibly relevant and would overcome a lot of society's challenges today if we lived in family, whānau, community.
It says in the classical texts, probably attributed to Lao Tzu, that the supple will always overcome the strong. So Bruce Lee framed it in a different way. Be like water. Water fills up a vessel, it goes through rocks. The water will always overcome. It can always break through in the end. It can be strong, but in nature, it's quite soft. Everything you ever dreamed of is on the other side of fear. When a boy